Hey, this is SGU, and welcome back to my Hartford Whalers relocation franchise series, formerly the Florida Panthers. We moved to Hartford in our inaugural season here, at least as the reincarnation of the Hartford Whalers. Obviously, the original franchise is in Carolina now. We suffered two tough losses in our last episode at the hands of the Pittsburgh Penguins and then the Chicago Blackhawks. Very different games, but the same result, frustration on the Hartford bench. So now we turn our attention to the LA Kings coming to town. They're 7-4. We're all of a sudden 6-6 and very much needing a win for our psyche, for our confidence. As we know, this roster is too talented to be playing 500 hockey. So let's see if we can take our frustration out on the LA Kings, as they are the next opponent into Taco Bell Arena here in Hartford. Oh, spin move, shot on net, rebound, going to be put behind the net, but then it gets back out in front, and it's a goal for Yossi Jokinen, and it's a milestone goal. As you're going to see, he gets mobbed here, and at first I'm like, what happened? What was the big deal? But this is his 200th career NHL goal. Now, we didn't immediately get an overlay saying that. It said it later as he was at the bench. Just says fourth goal of the season, but it is his 200th NHL goal, as it was shown later. So a big milestone there for Jokinen, and he puts us up 1-0 in our attempt to get a victory here tonight. That is certainly a good start. So we'll take the lead and run with it, take our chances. Let's see how we respond here now. Can we keep the lead? We've had leads in previous games and have not been able to hold them. Here we try to get the puck out of our own end, and eventually we will. Here we've got maybe a 3-on-2 if we hurry. Nice passing. That's a whiff on the shot. Rebound, and it ends up in the net. It's Thomas Vanek with the rebound goal. The initial shot attempt was completely whiffed by Bukestad. He then does put it on net, and the rebound finds Thomas Vanek's stick, his fourth of the season. Right there you see completely misses, but that fakes out the goalie. Has to make a quick save and cannot locate that rebound before Vanek puts it right out of midair and into the net. That's good quick reflexes and hand-eye coordination for Thomas Vanek, the free agent signee. Can we make it 3-0? Another rush? Nope, that's stopped by the Kings, and they're coming the other way here now. They do not have numbers, but that's a nifty pass right there, and oh, that's a soft goal. Just centers this here, looking for a one-timer. Instead, it hits Luongo's pads and goes in. Don't think he was expecting the puck to come quite at that angle. Tanner Pearson gets the goal, and it's cut the lead in half now, 2-1. We're in the third period, and a huge hit right there. Gonna have to take another look at this one. Ah, puts his shoulder right into him. That's Barkov, I believe, laying the smackdown, trying to keep our physical edge in this game. We win a third period faceoff, and Riley Smith is off to the race as a nice pass, and he scores. It's going to give us a two-goal lead back. Riley Smith has been red hot of late, even though the team hasn't. And he scores yet another. Hartford leads 3-1 with about 16 minutes to play. That's his sixth goal of the season. Start tallying just about in every game, it seems like, lately. And that is a great pass to spring his breakaway. And he does the rest. Nice forehand goal. Has the goalie out at the top of the crease and is able to put it past him. So 10 minutes to play now, winning a faceoff in our own end. Gonna send this down for what looks like icing, unless we can win the race to it. And oh my goodness, what a hit. I think he glitched out, he got hit so hard. And well, they take offense to that. Gonna be completely different players facing off here, but tensions have risen, and why not? Let's get some fisticuffs going here. See if we can win this battle as well. Dustin Brown taking on Brickley, and yeah, I don't know if I would get into this if I were Dustin Brown, and yeah, he pays the price. He loses this fight handily, so this crowd already amped up. That was a huge hit behind the net, and I guess Dustin Brown just sticking up for his teammate, although it's kind of weird he didn't go after the guy who delivered the big hit. Either way, this place is jacked up with just seconds left, and the Kings trying to get a goal. Nice mid-air deflection there, but Luongo keeps it out. Gonna play this just quickly to let the time run out, and finally Hartford gets a victory. It's been a little while, but we needed that one. It's a 3-1 final, in front of the home crowd. Maybe this will be the momentum we need now to get back on track. Now 7-6 on the season. Little salute to the fans for helping us through. And we will check out our three stars of the game. All Hartford Whalers, Riley Smith, Thomas Vanek, and Nick Bugstad, your three stars. So now, oh goody, we get to go back to Pittsburgh to play the Penguins again. We saw them in the last episode, and they beat us in kind of a shootout. Not an actual shootout, mind you, just a high-scoring game is exactly what I mean. And now it looks like the Penguins are going to wear their blue alternate throwbacks tonight. As you see, Sidney Crosby leading the league in assists coming into this game. We'll see if he tallies any more. Big hit right there at the blue line, separated from the puck, but he gets up and gets it back. And Luongo's got to make a huge glove save to keep that puck out of the net. Penguins are determined to storm the net there despite the big hit. They keep on going. So now in the first period, trying to get control of the puck behind the net with the forecheck. We're eventually going to turn it over right here. Is that onside? Yes, it stays onside. Put on net, the save, but not on the rebound. It's a goal for the Whalers, and they're up 1-0. Is it Riley Smith again? This guy is unstoppable. And Marc-Andre Fleury just found that out as he scores his 7th of the season now. Seems to be around the net, and the puck just happening to find him wherever he's at, whether it's a breakaway or whether it's a rebound like this. Riley Smith continues to provide the offense for us. So we're up 1-0. Second period. Penguins cycling the puck around. And inexplicably left someone wide open at the side of the crease. That's Carl Hagelin. And he will gladly get the equalizer there on my defensive gaffe. 1-1 hockey game now in Pittsburgh. I think the final was something like 5-4 the last time we were here. We're into the third period, and this is a much lower scoring game. We win the faceoff in the offensive zone, and wouldn't you know, it ends up in the back of the net. That's Ekblad with the blast and the goal, 2-1 Hartford, just a minute into the third period, and that's his third of the season from the blue line. Take another look at this one. You see the faceoff win. Slide that over to Ekblad, and he lets it go. Don't think it was really much of a screen. Yeah, well, maybe he was screened by his defenseman. Either way, Fleury cannot make the save, and we got a 2-1 hockey game. We're into the third period now, about 15 minutes left. Riley Smith, he's already got a goal, and now he's got a break, and oh, he's stopped by Fleury right there. Almost made it 3-1. He gets the puck back, trying to find a teammate. That's broken up. Now Pittsburgh trying to tie this thing up late. That's a save by Luongo, trying to keep this right at 2-1 and pick up our second straight victory. He'll have to be strong in net down the stretch. It's a face-off win for Pittsburgh. And a second attempt on the net. Again, a save for Luongo. Under 5 minutes to play now. Huberdeau with the puck, trying to center this one. A chance, a save. Knocked out of midair, but somehow, some way that stays out of the net. Looks like he batted that one right at Fleury instead of the wide open net. So here is a face-off win. A blocked shot, but the rebound goes in the net. Now 3-1 Hartford, hopefully with a commanding lead with under 3 minutes to play. Pittsburgh fans and mascots alike not liking what they see, but Vinny Trocheck gets the goal. We've had a lot of goals like this where it's either a whiff or a deflection or a block, and then the surprise rebound shot, as you see, it just kind of turns and rifles that one, and Fleury not expecting it at that time from that angle. It's 3-1 Hartford. Hit right there, but a whistle and a penalty with 43 seconds left. That's going to be Bukestad going to the box, and we are giving Pittsburgh a power play late. Don't want to be doing that. Let's see what he's got here. Yeah, well, they're going to call that. Give him 2 minutes for cross-checking. Let's see if we can fend off this power play and last gasp effort for the Penguins. It's another save by Luongo, who's been strong in net tonight. This puck played out to center ice. A chance at the empty net and a goal. That will seal it. Making up for our last visit here into Pittsburgh and then some, we're going to take home a 4-1 victory. And that is going to feel great here after dropping a few games in a row. Now able to start a winning streak and beating a quality team like Pittsburgh on their home ice. Redemption for the Hartford Whalers. We take this one 4-1 as it is all over. A victory for Luongo and a strong performance in net. Will it net him one of the three stars of the night? Let's take a look. Actually, he will not get one of the three stars, but Aaron Ekblad, your number one star in the victory. Unfortunately, we've got some injuries we're working through right now. Chason, he's got a strained hamstring. Vanek, who is out with a sore shoulder. That's kind of tough on our offensive efforts now, as we saw him score a goal in this episode. Anyway, we've fast-forwarded a few games, or at least one game. We're now 8-6, and we're taking on the 9-5 Anaheim Ducks next time. Come on back for more Hartford Whalers hockey. We will see you with that very soon.